Hello and welcome to this video in our SaaS series. In this video, we will learn the most important reporting tool in SaaS. It is called Proctabulate. Of all the reporting procedures used in SaaS, Proctabulate is the most widely used in the corporate sector. We will see how we write the syntax for this procedure, what this procedure can do, why is it so popular, and a lot more in this video. Other things like the ease with which we can use this tool, the speed at which reports are generated through Proctabulate also contribute to the fact that it is widely used. Let us look at the syntax now. We write Proctabulate followed by data is equal to the name of the data set. After this, we write options. We then use the class statement to put down the list of the variables, which will be in text format. By using the var statement, we will list down all the numeric variables on which we want to conduct any statistical or mathematical analysis. After that, we will write table to define the design of the table we generate. This is called the table dimension. We will look at it in more depth in a while. After that, we will again use some options and then finally run the command. This is the general syntax to generate a report through Proctabulate. But if we have used the ODS, Output Delivery System, to format the output of this proc step, say in Excel format or CSV format, then we use two more keywords. Formatting can have anything, say writing the headers in bold or coloring them to differentiate them from values, etc. The two new keywords that will be used are class level, which is written as class lev, followed by the list of variables, and the other one is key label. Key label is not used now because we can directly do this in the table statement. We will first look at the table dimension. We have three keywords for the table dimension. First one is space, as in the space we put using the space bar. The second one is comma, and the third one is asterisk. These are the three things used for table dimension. If we use space between two variables, then two separate tables will be created. Let us see this by importing a data set. The name of the file is final report, which has the following variables. So we write Proctabulate. Data is equal to final report. In the class statement, we take region and city variables. Remember, it has to be text variables over here. For now, we are not using the var statement. After that, we write table, followed by region and city with a space in the middle. We run the command now. This is the kind of table that will be generated. Both the variables have separate tables, which are separated by a column divider. Let us increase the width or the line size to see it clearly. For that, we write options no date, no number, and line size equal to 180. We increase the page size also to 100. As we run this, we can see that different statistics for both region and city have been generated. In region, we have north, south, east and west, all the values basically. What is N? N is the number of observations. The numbers corresponding to the regions tell us that east has 19 observations, north has 88, south has 4, and similarly, west has 82 observations. Since we have not considered any numeric variable in our code, that is why SAS is giving us the count or frequency of the text variables by default. We use the format statement to remove the decimal places since they won't be required in case of frequencies. This is what we got when we used space between region and city. Now we will see what will happen if we use comma between them. What comma does is that it takes the value before the comma as the row label and the one after the comma as the column label. Basically, it works like the matrix thing where you first mention the rows and then the columns. Let us see how it works in Excel first. Suppose this is the data set. Let us create a pivot table out of this. If we have used comma, then region will be taken in rows since it is before comma, and city will be displayed in columns since it is after the comma. The cells in the middle will show the count for the cities across regions. This is the kind of report we will get. Now we will run this in SAS and see we get the exact same table as we saw in the pivot table. Let us see what will happen if we add another variable store name to this. Now we have two commas in the table dimension. In such a scenario, what will happen? If we consider the second comma, then both region and city should be in rows. If we consider the first comma, then both city and store name should be in columns. So how will we decide which variable will be in row and which one will be in column? The way this is dealt in SAS is that we look at the second comma first. So city will be displayed in rows and store name will be shown in columns. Then we come to the first comma. And here region is then considered as the page field. City is known as the row field and store name is known as the column field. What do we mean by page field? Page field means that for every value of region, SAS will create a separate page. Hence, in every page for a region, we will show city in rows and store name in columns. Thus, we will get four pages of north, east, west, and south. How would this kind of a report look in pivot table? This is what it would have looked like. There would be report filters for every value in the region variable. For east, this is how it will look. Similarly, we can see it for other regions. Let us now run this and see it in SAS. We can see that we get the exact result with four reports segregated based on the region. Every report has city names in rows and store names in columns. We can clear all these reports by using the shortcut Ctrl plus E. Till now, we have only used text variables. Let us now introduce a numeric variable. Suppose we take city variable for text and plastic variable for numeric. Hence, we write the var statement. In table dimension, we write city, comma plastic. Since we used comma, we will get city in rows and the plastic variable will be in column. By default, for numeric data, SAS gives the sum for the variable. Now we will use the third option, asterisk. Again, we take our original code and put asterisks between region and city. The report generated through this looks like this. The city variable has been placed under region itself. In east, we have just got one city. In north, we have five cities and so on. Basically, it makes a nested report. Hence, the three different options do the following. Space creates a parallel report for the variables. Comma separates a report by defining row and column variables. And asterisk, as mentioned, creates a nested report. Let us now create a new report. We want to create a report of plastic sales based on the region. We will now see some options in tweaking these reports. Now we add city also to our report. It will be important for us to understand how we want this report to look like now, and that will determine the table dimension statement. Here we want the city to be embedded in the region. Hence, for that we use asterisk. So we write table followed by region, then asterisk, and then city. We run this proc step now to generate the report. We can see that since we had put region and city on the left hand side of comma, they are shown in rows and city is embedded in region itself. What if we put store name also in this report? Remember to make sure that all the variables mentioned in the table dimension should be mentioned either in the class statement or the var statement. We can see that the table has been first divided based on region, then in that there is subdivision based on city followed by store name. In every report, we are seeing that by default we are getting the sum of all the values for plastic. It means the variable can be defined like this also, plastic star sum. If we run this command, then also we get the same result. There is a very simple rule we follow if we do not want something. So say, we do not want the word sum. For that, we will just write is equal to and put a blank in double inverted commas here. You can see that the word sum is gone. If say, we do not want to see the word plastic, for that we will write the same thing in front of plastic now. As we run it, we can see that the header is not there anymore. Similarly, we can do it for others as well. Basically, whichever label or name we do not want to display, we have to just put a blank in inverted commas in front of that word. Now we want to add more numeric variables to this table. Here, we enter food, other, and liquid to the already existing plastic variable. By default, we will get the sum for all the numeric variables. This is what we see in the report as well. We can see the different variables being given row and column labels. The reason why the structure is such because these three variables are nested, and for these four numeric variables, we have separate columns being generated since they are separated by space in the code. If we put them in brackets and write sum like this, then also we should get the same result. If we put sum is equal to blank, then that word will be removed from the report. Let us see another option. Say, we want more statistics for plastic and not just the sum. We want the sum, mean, max, standard deviation, range, and Cole PCT sum. Cole PCT sum means column percentage against the sum value. Similarly, we have row PCT sum for row percentage against sum value. Let us understand Cole PCT sum through this table. So we have the sum for plastic variable here. If we sum up all the values, we will get the sum of them too. The percentage of the value with respect to the grand total is what we call Cole percentage sum or Cole PCT sum. Say we want the number of observations 2 in this example. For that, we write n and sum in brackets. As we run this, we get this report. The number 6 here shows the frequency for Big Bazaar. We can get the grand total we were talking about just now by writing the keyword all over here. We will discuss about this in more detail. So Cole PCT sum will basically find out the percentage of 627 with 15,036 as the denominator. Similarly, we can get the percentage of the column showing the frequency, that is n. This would then be called Cole PCT n, that is column percentage against n. Row PCT n would sum the values of all n's across the rows and then find the percentage contribution of each value to that sum. Row PCT sum would then obviously be calculated on the basis of the sum of all the products across a single row. Let us now run this command. We can see that Proctabulate has generated all these statistics for the plastic variable. That is how quick and easy it can get through this procedure. Cole PCT sum shows that 627 is just 4% of the sum for that column, which is approximately 15,000. Suppose we want to rename these statistics to make it more presentable. Thus, we rename sum as total, mean to be average, max as highest, STD as standard deviation, range is kept as it is, and Cole PCT sum is renamed as percentage against column. We can see we have gotten the desired report with the desired names for statistics. Now we shall understand what the all keyword is. We generate this table once again. By default, all the reports are generated in the center. In case we do not want it there, then we can write the option No Center over here. By doing this, we see that the report is now being generated towards the left. We also remove the word sum. Just to make it simple for us to understand the role of the keyword all, we take only two variables in the class statement. We thus have region, store name, and the four numeric values in our table. So whichever variable's total we want to see, we write all keyword after that. For now, region and store name are nested. That is why if we write all here, The result will be given at the bottom of the table. We can rename or give the label to all also. Say grand total. We get a more presentable report now. In some cases, we can use the keyword key label to rename all to grand total. As mentioned earlier, key label is not used anymore. We do this thing in the table statement itself. Now suppose we want the total for the regions also, as in the total for north, total for south, and so on. For that we will write all in front of store name only. Remember to put the brackets. If we forget the brackets, then we will again get the total for all the regions together since the two variables are nested. Now you can see we get the totals for all the stores in every region. Let us rename this as region total for presentation purpose. We can see the amount of flexibility we are getting through Proctabulate. Let us look at another option called box option. We can see here that there is a blank box in the report. What might be the purpose of this blank box? We can use this box to write something for reference with respect to the report being generated. Where do we write this in the code? It is given in the table statement at the end after inserting a slash. We write box is equal to say region-wise report for the year 2017. Now we run this command. We can see that the box now contains exactly the text that we had mentioned over there. If we have to increase or decrease the column width of these numeric variables, then we can do it using the format statement like this. We can see that as we increased the number from 10 to 15, the width of the columns has increased significantly. However, for the headers for the variables in rows, their width can be increased or reduced by using the option called RTS. We can use this option before or after the box one here. RTS stands for row title space. We write RTS equal to 35. We can see the report now. Say we change it to 60, and we can see that the row title space has increased significantly. This is how we can play around with options in Proctabulate. This is it for this video. Thank you.